हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस। इन अर्लियर वीडियो ऑफ पार्शियल फ्रैक्शन वी हैड सीन द प्रॉपर एंड इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शंस। इन प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी हैड सीन हाउ टू फाइंड द पार्शियल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू फाइंड द पार्शियल फ्रैक्शंस ऑफ इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन। सो नाउ once again let us revise the proper and improper concept. So as you know, proper fraction is a fraction when the degree of x in numerator is less than the degree of x in denominator, right? And fraction is improper fraction when the degree of x in numerator, highest degree of x in numerator, is either greater than or equal to the highest degree of x in denominator, right? Then fraction is a improper. Now if the fraction is improper fraction, then how to resolve into partial fractions? So see the example. Question is, resolve into partial fractions. What is given? X square plus 1 upon x square minus 1. Now this is not a proper fraction, this is improper fraction. Why? Because highest degree of x in numerator and highest degree of x in denominator both are same, right? X square in numerator, x square in denominator. So in both the places we are getting 2, and therefore numerator equal to denominator, and hence it is not a proper fraction, it is a improper fraction. So for improper fraction, first we have to convert this improper into proper. So how to convert this? So for conversion, we have to do the actual division method. That means we have to divide numerator with denominator. So let's see the division. So what I have to do? I have to divide numerator. Numerator is x square plus 1 with denominator. Denominator is x square minus 1, right? Now to get x square, I have to multiply this x square minus 1 with 1, right? So simple technique is, take the x term. X term is x square, right? And divide by x term of this, right? So x term of divisor is x square. Divide this, what I am getting? 1. So 1 will be a quotient, right? So multiply quotient with divisor. So 1 into x square minus 1 will be a x square minus 1. Now change the sign. So here it is plus, so it will be minus. Here it is minus, so it will be a plus. So x square minus x square cancel. 1 plus 1 will be a 2. Okay, division clear? How to divide? Once again, see, x square plus 1 divided by denominator is x square minus 1. So what we have to do? We have to take the first x term. First x term is x square, and we will divide this first x term with x term of divisor. So first x term of divisor is x square. So x square cancel, remainder is 1, right? So 1 will be a quotient. Multiply this whole term with 1. So 1 into x square will be x square, 1 into minus 1 will be minus 1. Now see the sign. What is the sign for x square? Plus. So change the sign, minus. Here it is minus, so change the sign, that will be a plus. Cancel 2, right? So next, see, this is the actual division procedure. Now next, what I have to do? I have to write this term, x square plus 1 upon x square minus 1. I have to write this fraction as quotient plus remainder upon divisor. Okay, I have to write this given fraction as quotient plus remainder upon divisor. So that will be a quotient is 1, remainder is 2, divisor is x square minus 1, right? So finally, what I am getting, x square plus 1 upon x square minus 1 is equal to quotient is 1, remainder is 2 upon x square minus 1, right? After actual division, I am getting these terms, quotient, remainder and divisor. Okay, then I have to write this as quotient plus remainder upon divisor form. So from this second part, remainder upon divisor, this is a proper fraction. This is known as a proper fraction. Okay, this is a proper fraction. Now I got the proper fraction. So next step is, take this proper fraction separately and find the partial fraction of proper fraction. Okay, so to convert improper into proper, what we have to do? We have to do the actual division and then we have to write in quotient plus remainder upon divisor form. Then we will get proper fraction. Okay, so from that we have to take this proper fraction and then we have to resolve this proper fraction into partial fractions. Okay, now I took this 2 upon x square minus 1. Now x square minus 1, it is a quadratic equation, but we can factorize this x square minus 1 as x minus 1 into x plus 1. Okay, so after factorizing, I am getting linear non-repeated factors. Okay, so which rule is applicable? Rule number 1. Factors are linear and non-repeated. So that will be a A upon first factor, means A upon x minus 1, plus B upon second factor. Second factor is x plus 1. So A up second factor is x plus 1. So A upon x minus 1 plus B upon x plus 1. Okay. Now do the cross multiplication. So after cross multiplying, what we are getting? A into x plus 1 plus B into x minus 1 into denominator will be x minus 1 into x plus 1. Right. Now in both the side, denominator is common. So cancel out the denominator. Then we will get equation as 2 is equal to A into x plus 1 plus B into x minus 1. Right. We got this equation. 2 is equal to A into x plus 1 plus B into x minus 1. Now we have to substitute the values of x. So let the first factor x minus 1 equal to 0. So by substituting x minus 1 as 0, we have to substitute x as 1. So 2 is equal to A into 1 plus 1. X minus 1 is 0. So second term will be 0. So that means 2 is equal to 2A. And hence A is equal to 1. Okay. Now take the second factor equal to 0. Second factor is x plus 1 equal to 0. So that means x equal to minus 1. When x equal to minus 1, then we get 2 is equal to 0 plus b into minus 1 minus 1. So that means 2 is equal to minus 2b. Okay, so b is equal to minus 1. Okay, after getting a and b value, we have to put this a and b value. But this is not a complete answer, right? This is a part of given fraction, right? Given fraction is x square plus 1 upon x square minus 1, right? For that we have written this as x square plus 1 upon x square minus 1. We had written this as 1 plus 2 upon x square minus 1. Okay. And then what we had done? We find the partial fractions of 2 upon x square minus 1, and partial fractions of 2 upon x square minus 1 is 1 upon x minus 1 minus 1 upon x plus 1. Then in last step we have to substitute this fractions, this proper partial fractions in this place. So the final answer is 1 plus 1 upon x minus 1 minus 1 upon x plus 1. These are the partial fractions of x square plus 1 upon x square minus 1. Okay, so this is the way when the given fraction is improper, then in this way we can resolve into, first we have to convert into proper fraction, and then we resolve the proper fraction in partial fractions. Okay, so one more example. See what is given. Resolve into partial fraction. Question is x raised to 4 upon x square plus 1. Now numerator is x raised to 4. In denominator there is x cube. It is x cube, not square. So x raised to 4 upon x cube plus 1. So numerator x raised to 4 is given, and in denominator x cube is given, right? So numerator is greater than the denominator, and hence it is not a proper fraction. So first what we have to do, we have to divide, right? So let's see the division. X raised to 4 divided by x cube plus 1. Okay, so we have to take this x raised to 4 and divided by x raised to 3. Cancel. So what is remaining? X. So this x will be a quotient. Now multiply the whole term with this x. So x into x cube, that will be a x raised to 4, plus 1 into x will be a x. Change the sign, minus minus. So this term is cancelled. So minus x. Okay. So after doing this actual division, we have to write partial fraction x raised to 4 upon x cube plus 1 as quotient plus remainder upon divisor. Quotient is x, right? Quotient is x plus remainder is minus x upon divisor is x cube plus 1. So plus minus will be a minus. So x minus x upon x cube plus 1. Now this x upon x cube plus 1, this is a proper fraction. Okay, after getting this proper fraction, next we have to resolve this proper fraction into partial fractions. So this x cube plus 1, right? We can factorize this x cube plus 1 as x plus 1 into x square minus x plus 1, right? A cube plus b cube formula. A cube plus b cube is a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. Okay, so after applying this formula, we can get factors of x cube plus 1 as x plus 1 into x square minus x plus 1. Okay, now see, first factor is a linear factor. So partial fraction will be a upon x plus 1. Now second factor, x square minus x plus 1. This factor is a quadratic factor, right? Quadratic equation. Quadratic, but we cannot reduce this quadratic equation, and hence it is a quadratic irreducible factor, right? Quadratic, but irreducible, and hence numerator will be bx plus c. Okay, now do the cross multiplication. After cross multiplying, we get this equation. Okay, then procedure is same. First we have to put x is equal to माइनस वन. ओके, फर्स्ट फैक्टर इक्वल टू जीरो, सो एक्स इक्वल टू माइनस वन. व्हेन एक्स इज माइनस वन देन वी गेट वैल्यू फॉर ए, ए इज माइनस वन अपॉन थ्री. देन नाउ टेक सेकेंड वैल्यू फॉर एक्स, सो पुट एक्स इक्वल टू जीरो एंड ए इक्वल टू माइनस वन अपॉन थ्री, सो वी गेट सी वैल्यू. ओके, सी विल बी वन अपॉन थ्री. नाउ टू फाइंड द थर्ड कॉन्स्टेंट वी हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट वन मोर वैल्यू फॉर एक्स, सो कंसिडर एक्स एज वन, ए माइनस वन अपॉन थ्री एंड सी वन अपॉन थ्री. ओके, देन बाय सॉल्विंग वी गेट बी एज वन अपॉन थ्री. आफ्टर गेटिंग ए बी एंड सी वैल्यूज वी हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट दैट इन पार्शल फ्रैक्शंस, टेकिंग वन अपॉन थ्री कॉमन एंड सॉल्विंग वी गेट पार्शल फ्रैक्शन एज वन अपॉन थ्री इंटू एक्स प्लस वन अपॉन एक्स स्क्वेयर माइनस एक्स प्लस वन. ओके, आई एम टेकिंग दिस पॉजिटिव टर्म आउटसाइड, देन माइनस वन अपॉन एक्स प्लस वन. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द पार्शल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ गिवन फ्रैक्शन. सो आफ्टर दिस टेक डाउन सम एग्जाम्पल फॉर प्रैक्टिस. ओके, देर आर टू क्वेश्चंस, बोथ आर इम्प्रॉपर फ्रैक्शन. फर्स्ट वन इज इम्प्रॉपर बिकॉज न्यूमरेटर इज ग्रेटर देन डिनोमिनेटर. सेकेंड वन इज ऑल्सो इम्प्रॉपर बिकॉज न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर बोथ आर हैविंग सेम डिग्री, राइट? हेंस बोथ आर इम्प्रॉपर. सो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट into a proper fraction and then for proper fraction you have to find the partial fractions. Okay, now solution is given, final answer is given, so you solve and check whether you are getting the same answer or not. So with this I am concluding my video. We are completing this partial fractions chapter. So thank you students.